Now this is the parallel plate capacitance. Okay, so parallel plate wiring capacitance, you can see that wiring capacitance will depend upon the width as well as length of the transistor. Okay, so we know that parallel plate to plate capacitance is A epsilon by D. So A is what? A is the area of the that is cross sectional area. Okay, epsilon is the relative permittivity, and TDI is the distance between the two plates of the capacitor. Okay, so that is what they are trying to say from this. So permittivity constant, so they are using a dielectric of silicon dioxide. Okay, and these are the electric fields of line they are using. Fine. So this is what a normal parallel plate capacitor is. Now you're seeing one figure, so you can see the different sources of resistances. So this is you can say the layout form. You are seeing one poly is there, right? And drain is there, that is active is there. Okay, so when you run a poly on active, so during that time a transistor is formed wherever active and poly will cross. Okay, so this is the width of the transistor and this is the length of the transistor. So this so what all the factors that are contributing the resistance we'll see here. MOS structure resistance, so because the structure of MOS is like that, because of that also resistance is there, so that is on resistance. Source and drain resistance, so because of source and because of drain some resistance is there. Contact via resistance, so whether we are going with contact or whether we are going with via, that will also offer in resistance. Then wiring resistance. So these are the four sources of resistance that are available because of the MOS structure. Okay, so we'll see one by one what all things are those. Now coming to the MOS structure resistance. So the simplest model assumes the transistor is a switch with the infinite off resistance and finite on resistance. So what they are trying to say is that when you are using MOS transistor in digital as a switch, so during that time when you are applying a voltage greater than threshold voltage, then your MOS transistor will work in the your MOS transistor is on and having a finite resistance. So when your input voltage is less than the threshold voltage, so during that time it is off. So you see this switch. When gate to source voltage, so when gate to source voltage is greater than threshold voltage, then only this switch is closed and your MOS will act as a MOS is having some finite resistance. So when your gate voltage is less than threshold voltage, so it will act as an open circuit and it is off. So that is what they are trying to say from MOS structure resistance. However, R on is non-linear, so we use instead the average value of the resistance R equal at the end points of the transition. So what they are trying to say that at different voltages VDD and VDD by 2, they are calculating the on resistance. At T1 they are applied VDD and they calculated the resistance, on resistance. At VDD2 also they have calculated the on resistance, and after that they took the average of that and they got the equivalent resistance. Okay, so this is the equivalent resistance at T1 and T2. So R equivalent equal to 3 by 4 VDD by ID set 1 minus 5 by 6 lambda VDD. So this is the equivalent resistance of the equivalent resistance of the MOS. Okay, so this is the equivalent resistance at two different endpoints. Okay, half of this.